Previously on The Witcher 3.
Next time I'll rip your fucking legs off and shove them up your ass till you've toes for teeth.
Dandelion's pretty loose-lipped. Might have blabbed something to a lady friend that'll put us on his trail.
That's what I'm counting on. We should divide these somehow. Perhaps... Ah, fuck it. I'll ask the lassies in my half, you interrogate the ones in yours.
Reason for all this sneaking around?
An excellent one. When last I saw Dandelion, he told me he was planning a heist. Siggy Reuven's vault?
Sheepdip.
And I've not seen him since.
Anybody there? Open up.
What's the fuss? The bathhouse is closed.
Need to talk to the owner. I know he's here.
I'm not sure that matters, as he's terribly busy.
Tell him Geralt of Rivia wants to talk to him.
I cannot promise Mr. Reuven we'll have time to see you.
Want a bed?
Very well, I shall try. Please wait.
Siggy Reuven cordially invites you to join him. I'm happy. The meeting is in the baths. We will pass through the dressing room so you can leave your clothes.
Let's go.
You may disrobe here. Your equipment will be safe. Splendid. Siggy Reuven awaits in the next room.
Hi, Whitehair. Nice bum you have.
You were right. He doesn't blush.
Junior cut off his hand, then ordered them to shove it up the corpse's arse. And then he sent the body back, offering a hand extended in peace.
He's hung like a horse.
Clear that you've not seen Reuben's.
Gudrun calls it Herberos.
You copy it, you got it.
Does it loop back on itself?
Easy, Cleaver.
Our son Junior's a dead man. I'll have my scribe send you a notice.
You don't have a scribe. And we'll eliminate Junior when, and only when, all of us say aye.
Reuben, your guest.
Why the fuck you let him in here? Because I want to talk to him. This is Geralt of Rivia.
Good to see you again.
As always, I'm out of the swiving loop. Who the fuck are you?
Think I'll let your host introduce me.
He's a witcher. The very one who first foiled an attempt on Foltest's life, and then killed that monarch.
Allegedly. But I didn't kill Foltest. And hello to you too, Dijkstra, Reuven. Whatever they call you these days.
Last we met, Geralt thrashed me silly and crushed my ankle. I really wonder what he's got in store this time.
Got intruders. Someone just snuck inside the bathhouse. Several men.
What the fuck's he on about? Plowing fortune teller?
Assassins! Please, no! Ah!
Bloody hell. I fucking knew it.
Any weapons tucked away?
Just a few.
First ever party with my prick hanging out.
This is killing. Old son Junior sends his
not one in sight! Got it!
We need one alive!
Good work, gents. Terribly sorry for that incident. My security failed. I'll get to the bottom of who, why, and how.
They were horse and scum. That's the bottom of who and how right there.
Don't start that again. Especially not in front of our guest.
Who pranced in right before they attacked. Coincidence? Why do I doubt it?
Let's give him a chance to explain.
Not gonna introduce me to your friends?
Good thing happens not here. He'd tan the hide on my ass for being so rude. Francis Bedlam, you know, but then who's not heard of this patron of the fine arts and supporter of entrepreneurs of limited initial means? And the dwarfs Carlo Varese, known also as Cleaver. Carlo's in entertainment, mostly.
I'm looking for Horson Jr.
Interesting.
What do you want with him?
It's personal.
Geralt takes his privacy very seriously. Spying on him, having him followed, was a bloody nightmare.
Still, he was lots more trusted when he was looking for Marigold.
Gentlemen, you out of your fucking minds? A chat session? Horse son's out to get us, and he'll succeed, eventually. we've got to kill him first. So by all means, you sit here, soak, fart, and watch the bubbles rise while I send my boys to Horse Sun's hidey holes. They'll make some noise, flush the bugger out. And you, geriatric, or whatever your ploughing name is, want to find Horse Sun? Find me first.
Any clue on Junior's whereabouts? Be grateful for any lead.
Siggy? It's worth a try. Geralt's got a knack for finding people. And he's discreet, a value in itself. Leave you to it, then.
I'll look in on you tomorrow, Francis. Finish our talk.
So how about we get dressed?
Sure, sure. Then we'll talk. In private. Right mess that was. Never thought I'd be glad to see the man responsible for my taking frequent baths.
If you're any cleaner for it, gotta say it was worth breaking your ankle.
It healed poorly. Can you believe it? I must soak it in hot water at least 6 times a day now. Failing that, it bloody pounds like the bells of Beauclair at dawn.
I had my reasons. Your leg would be fine if you hadn't gotten in my way.
I see. Well, I promise you that if I could go back in time, I'd do things quite differently on Thanet. For example, I'd have my men kill you instead of just tying you up.
Listen, Reuven. No, Dijkstra. Just not in the mood for your code names, passwords, and other bullshit. I'm here on specific business. If you want to listen, listen. If not, I'd rather you spared me your wit and threw me out now.
What's the harm? Talk.
You think Cleaver will find Horson?
He might. He might not. But he'll burn down half the city trying. What waste. Leave him to it, I say. Work alone.
Any ideas?
Junior's got areas of the city where he's strong. Penetrate them, look around. But be discreet. None of this speed and fury and swinging your steel cock about.
Makes sense to ask around, I guess. Junior might be in hiding, but he's got to be collecting income. Couldn't afford to cut himself off.
Gambling, that's his big earner. Junior controls the largest casino in town. I'll never forget. Hierarch Hemelfart raised all kinds of hallowed hell there once. Bugger bet and lost his ruby ring. Then there's the arena in the city's bowels. Betting scheme generates near as much as the casino. They're always looking for hired muscle there.
Suppose you could always search Horson's house. Though I doubt you'll find him there. Maybe some clue, though.
Where's Junior's casino?
Near the Temple Watch Towers. Horson's got nought to do with the casino officially. So careful what you say. Try not to arouse any suspicions.
Arena sounds promising. Where's that?
Sewers beneath Gildorf. But you'll have to enter through the bits. Endure the stench of poverty on the way. Now, Junior loves a good fight. Wager he'd give a lot to see a real witcher in action.
Mentioned Horson's got a house. Where is it?
Solid townhouse on Temple Isle, just on the other side of the bridge. Wouldn't wager me knickers on finding him there. Junior's not that stupid.
See if I can't find Horson at the casino or the arena. Might talk to Cleaver as well, though.
Do what you will. Just be cautious. Horson's expecting payback, I've no doubt.
Thanks for your help, Dijkstra.
Just go, Witcher. And if you can't find the slimy bastard, come and see me. I know him well. Might figure something out.
Listen, Dandelion's missing. Any idea what might have happened to him?
Same thing that happens to anyone who steps on Junior's toes.
Meaning?
He's surrounded by splendid virgins who ply him with sparkling wine and pastries stuffed with nightingales' tongues. Come, Geralt, what do you think's happened to him? I reckon he's at the bottom of the Pontar, trussed up with the strings of his own mandolin.
Loot.
Far as I'm concerned, he might as well be rotting down there with a goddamn trombone.
You wouldn't happen to have a bone to pick with Dandelion, would you?
course I do.
You serious?
Dead serious. Dandelion published a sonnet recently. Second stanza, the shit uses paired couplets instead of an inserted rhyme. Surely you understand how deeply offended the poetry lover in me was. The bastard shan't get away with it.
I was being serious.
As am I when I say I have exactly no time to worry about your gigolo boyfriend. Got me own problems. Problems you might be able to help me with. And if you did, why then I might be inclined to ask after Dandelion, establish what happened to him.
I'll get paid on top of that, right?
Nothing for free, eh? Did you bargain this hard when Emma wanted to hire you?
No idea what you're talking about.
You are the worst liar I have ever known. Glad I don't need you to win a poker game for me. But we've chatted enough. Yeah, I'll pay you. Count on it. So, can I count on you?
Maybe I can help. What do you need?
I'd rather show than tell. Picture's worth a thousand words and all that tripe. Ah, and you do realize, if you say anything about what you see here to anyone, it'll mean a razor between your ribs.
Figured as much.
Excellent. One last request. Oh, let's call it what it is. A command. Don't draw your sword unless I ask you to. So kind as to follow me. Oh, Bart, not again.
Bart.
Bart, stop that. Now.
Bart makes Ziggy lose, Jonathan.
Beating your head against the wall won't change that.
Bart hurt. Bart less thinky. Bart less thinky. Bart sadless.
Where'd you get the troll?
From Zerikania. Won him. Card game with a camel merchant.
Your jokes are getting better by the minute.
See me smiling? I'm dead serious.
But I bumpy horses. What's there? Ziggy Bart take. Good Ziggy.
Don't seem to have trouble communicating with the troll. Why'd you bring me down here?
Take note of that hole. We'll come back to it later. And see that door? Vault behind it, until recently filled with Novigrad crowns and countless other valuables.
But God! Then boom! Jorfund, go!
Translating into common, someone fucking made off with nearly 20 tons of my gold and all the lighter stuff. And you will help me get it back.
Why don't you handle this? Gotta have connections in the underworld. What do you need a witcher for?
The gold wasn't mine alone. See, I run a members-only savings club, a bank for the initiated. For reasons that should be obvious, I prefer it if my temporary liquidity problems remained private. So I need an outsider.
How do you know you can trust me?
I don't. Counting on your survival instinct. Slip up. And I'll kill you, feed you to Bart.
Bart, sorry. Bart job that good.
Fine, I'll help you.
You're not exactly bursting with enthusiasm.
Witcher mutations. They strip us of emotion. I'd be jumping for joy otherwise. All right. Ought to look around. But first, some questions.
I'm all ears.
Take it the thieves got in through the hole behind you.
You're a regular fucking master sleuth. Any other brilliant deductions you want confirmed? The year, maybe? Bloody name of Redania's king?
No, but I am wondering, for instance, how that hole got there.
Hole, no. Boom! Hole. Bat, look, won't go. Bat, look, no. Only sleep. Bad shrooms, head falls.
Boom. Can you elaborate?
Boom! Big, dislike.
I'll elaborate. Explosion, big enough to blow that fucking hole in the wall, separating the vault from the sewers.
Gotten pretty good at communicating with this troll.
Lots of prior experience. Worked with idiots my whole life.
Bad mushrooms? What's that about?
Pops mold. The spores are highly toxic. One whiff and you're dead. Unless you're a troll, that is.
Yes. Bad. Troll.
Not talking to you, dimwit. Where was I? Ah, mold spores. They cover the walls of the sewers other side of the vault. Actually thought it was a good thing, you know? A bit of extra protection. Thieves found a way through it.
Bart, you see them?
Bart, through hole. Once see, boom, got what? Breathe, shroom. Sleep go. Jorfun gone. Bad troll!
Now, stiff up a lip.
Try to track down the thief yourself?
Of course. Hired this lummox, Fonce, thick enough not to ask questions. We knocked back some Pop's antidote and entered the sewers. Soon after, I returned alone.
What happened?
Lad started belching something horrendous. I mean, burps with so much mass the walls shook. Told him, Fonce, stop. You're in the presence of a count. Well, former count, but still. And then he puked up. Up came most of the antidote. Lost his protection. Tried to pull him out. Then I heard a bubbling. Something crawled out of the water. I value the lives of my men, I do. But I value my own even more. Dropped Fonce and ran like hell.
Should look around the sewers. Got any more of that Pop's antidote?
Have a few vials left. Got the formula too. Disgusting swill, to be honest. But it'll save your life. Here.
Thanks.
You've naught to thank me for, literally. You're no good to me if you suffocate. Listen, I'll be upstairs if you need me. Sight of this empty vault's giving me an ulcer. Good luck to you.
Line just curled out. Yourself side door wide open. Wall too. Bathhouse drain pipes seem to converge here. Pipes great. Explosion crumpled it like a piece of paper. And there's mortar on the bars. So it was in place at the time of the explosion. Blast tore it from the wall. No traces of magic. This was no spell. It was a
Shouldn't
bomb.
Go any further.
I'd taken that out. Why am I not finding pieces of it?
Getting harder to breathe.
Bits of pipe clear over here. Must have been one powerful blast. Got a minute?
I do. What do you want?
Done. Examined every nook of the sewers near your vault.
Well, learn anything?
seems to me a bomb blew the wall open. Look.
Bottom of a silver cylinder, probably. Covered in runes. Interesting. Any idea what it contained?
Recognized some ingredients by their scent. Wyvern oil and sugar.
Sugar? Geralt, I'm in no mood for jests.
Nor am I. Just saying what I found. Bomb contained sugar.
Let's think. Sugar would react violently with sulfuric acid, but not so violently to cause an explosion.
Didn't know you were versed in alchemy.
Dabbled in it a bit while at Oxenford Academy. But this is no time to reminisce. You're to find my treasure, not write my biography. Know anything else about this bomb? Anything at all?
Drain pipes are only promising lead. We just need to know which pool it's connected to.
Yes. Appen keeps a record of guests. Should be able to tell us who used that pool the day of the break-in. You've not done badly.
Feel honored to be acknowledged.
Oh, that famous sarcasm. I missed it.
Really?
About as much as I'd miss a knife in my knickers. All right. You inspect the pools on the right, I'll take the ones on the left. Holler if you find anything.
Silver lid. Matches the cylinder bottom I found in the sewer. Dijkstra, come here.
Got something?
Yeah. Bomb part.
Appen, drain pool 4 and bring me the guest book. Chop chop.
Let's see what's on the bottom. Grate's been removed from the drain, meaning they flushed the bomb down here.
Appen, who used this pool the day of the break-in?
Let me see. Berthold Heinz, town councilman, Josef Schweik, brewer, and Margrave Henkel.
Henkel? That's impossible.
Margrave Henkel, who's that?
Who was that, you mean? Old Coot's been eating dirt since last winter. Couldn't have been here the day of the break-in.
He's dead? I'd not heard.
Not surprising. The Honourable Margrave croaked in a brothel, decked out in leather lingerie, so the family held a hush-hush funeral. But I have my sources.
Yeah, I saw him that fateful day, Mr. Reuven. I'm certain of it.
Did you speak to him? Get a good look at him?
No. He merely passed by on the way in.
So you didn't see Henkel. You saw an impersonator. Think for once. They scooped out your balls, not your brain. And you, Geralt, start looking into this.
Fine. Where should I start?
Henkel's home. Derelict townhouse south of the main square. You might happen on some trace of this scoundrel we're looking for there. Well, off with you.
Floor is worn by a moving door. Something behind this wall. Strange. I wonder if Dijkstra knows Junior's made a deal with the Redanians.
Greetings! You here for a specific reason?
Got a meeting with Rosa, a fencing lesson.
Geralt of Rivia, yes? Miss Rosa stepped out for a walk. near Temple Bridge, she said. She asked that you join her.
Guess it's gonna be an interesting lesson. Thanks. Guardian Regiment always accompany you on your walks?
Always. Papa's orders. It's for your protection, Rosa dear. People here hate us. Why? What have I done to them? But enough about that. Soldier, you may leave.
But His Excellency Ambassador Bar-Atra said that...
And this Excellency is telling you otherwise. Do you not recognize him? This is Geralt of Rivia, the best swordsman the North has ever seen. I'm safe with him. Now march off, quickly. Left, right, left, right. Finally. Let's go, Geralt. I've something I wish to show you.
You're using me. Don't like it one bit.
And I don't like lacy frills and Redanian novels, but you don't hear me complaining. Now follow me.
In this city, racial hygiene's as poor as their personal hygiene.
Here. You see, I thought that instead of training in a dank old cellar, we'd move around in the open air. A duel on a bridge. Like in the novels. Now draw your sword.
Only got my steel and silver swords. We should be fighting with practice weapons.
We should, but you of all people ought to know, there's much more fun in doing things you shouldn't.
Listen, I'd really rather not hurt you.
Stop patronizing me, or you'll be the one to get hurt. Now on guard.
Die.
Ow! Ow! Stop! I yield!
You all right?
Yes. The only thing you've really hurt is my pride.
By the way, how'd you get interested in fencing?
I was bored. I've no friends here. Papa keeps me on a short lead. It's banquet after banquet after banquet. I detest banquets.
Boring conversations, terrible food, and weak booze.
Exactly. At least with a sword in hand, I can have some fun. You know, blow off steam.
All right, what's next?
We should return. Just forgive me, Geralt. I know this might sound awkward, but would you mind turning around for a moment? My corset's shifted. It's pinching me terribly.
I can understand a woman wanting to look pretty, but fighting in a corset, it slows you. Rosa? Shit, she ran off. Anything happens to her, Varadra will kill me. Need to find her. Can't be far.
Trouble?
Me and my friend could join you. Far from home, aren't you, sweetie? And there's no telling if you'll ever get back.
She's Ambassador Varatra's daughter. She's got diplomatic immunity.
I don't really understand the shite you're saying. Now it's clear you love your black ones.
It's no surprise, Lucas. Witches are drawn to monsters, just the way things are. But this beastie, we'll tend to her ourselves.
Let me rephrase, put it in words you'll understand. Piss off.
Well, well, it's not just black ones who tell us what to do. It's witches as well.
Too bad I listened to neither. Get him, Lucas!
Understand now why your father insists soldiers follow you around?
So they can save me, as you did.
No, so you won't need saving to begin with. Rosa, those humans died because of you.
What of it? Do you expect me to shed a tear? Observe a minute of silence? They were dregs. They got what they deserved.
And you wonder why the locals hate Nilfgaard.
I thought you were different from other Nordlings. That you understand us, our sense of justice. I see I was wrong.
You should go home now. And take the shortest, not the scenic route.
I understand. Farewell, Geralt. And good luck on the path.
Take it easy.
Why are you even here?
Same reason anyone comes here. Play a bit, have a good time.
Invite only, mate. Shit out of luck.
Gonna get in there. Better for you to let me in.
And if we don't, then what?
I'll kill you.
Do you get that?
Got it all right. He threatened us and reached for his weapon.
Die, you ploughing bastard. You try to smile.
Keep it together, legs.
Now!
You bored?
You alive?
Don't finish me.
Don't intend to.
Who the hell are you? I heard screaming downstairs.
It's all right now.
Will you help me?
You're not hurt all that bad. Let's talk first. Why are you here?
What's it look like? I came here to sit and think. God. All right. Clever and tough's not working for me. They took me for one of Bedlam's moles.
Are you?
Well, kinda, yeah.
So what have you kinda learned?
Horson's working hand in glove with the Redanians. I don't know the details, but he's on their side. And that's all I know.
Take care of yourself.
Thanks. I'll lay low until things settle down. Bedlam will learn you helped me. See him. He's sure to reward you.
Do. What do you want?
Wiley, Horson Jr. He's working with Radovid.
Huh? If this is reliable information, Horson's neck deep in shit.
Source seems reliable.
It would certainly explain how he had the nerve to break with the Big Four.
need someone who can get me in to see Junior. You must still have some contacts among the Redanians.
I don't, but you do.
Enlighten me.
Temerian, former commander of the Blue Stripes. Ring a bell?
Vernon Roach.
He's holed up with his men in a camp near Oxenford. Pay him a visit. You're sure to cheer him up, at least.
Hovel than a Margrave's townhouse. Dandelion made some interesting friends.
Thinking customer, you'll see right away I've got the best deals this side of the world.
Footprints. From your birth year. It's absolutely excellent. Startling bouquet. You absolutely must try it. But afterwards, please place the bottle back where you found it. Your birth year. Could be Dandelions. Or Ceres. /12:54. Satisfying click. In the next room over, I think. Secret room. Probably where Dandelion and his cohorts planned the heist. Siri, Menge is following me. He has seized the treasure. He has Dandelion. You must flee. Footsteps. Not good. Sugar. And lumps of a substance dipped in wyvern oil. Potassium? Looks like they made the bomb here. Instructions on how to build a bomb, signed by one Kalkstein. Stain. Wyvern oil. Didn't expect to see you here. Certainly not with Triss.
I decided we could use someone who knows a bit of magic. The runes on the bomb. I'm absolutely dying to know what they mean.
You dying to know too, Triss?
No, just here for the coin.
Ah, Marigold playing the cynical materialist. I love it. In truth, her ideals brought Triss here. She needs gold to save her colleagues. When I recover my treasure, I'll be in a position to help her. Simple as that. Speaking of which, and pardon my Beauchlairoise, have you found out who fucking nicked my gold?
Hang on. Gotta tell me why you're here first. We agreed. If I learned anything, I'd take it to you.
So we did. But I was concerned about you. Stopped by to see if everything was all right.
Bullshit. You don't trust me.
I trust you as much as you trust me. Not at all. Believe me, it's a healthy relationship.
Gentlemen, really feel privileged to witness your battle of wits. But try to remember, unlike you, I put my life at risk every time I venture out into the streets. Did the same just coming here. So I beg you, can we get to the point?
Bothered Triss for nothing. No point examining the bomb.
Because?
Because I already know who nabbed your treasure. Commander of the Temple Guard, Caleb Menge.
Well, well, Marigold. Your coin stands to come with a side of revenge. Geralt, would you be kind enough to tell me what you've learned? I'm terribly curious.
What I've learned doesn't matter.
Doesn't matter? Yet you agreed to help me.
I am. Doesn't mean I have to confess everything.
I'll let your insolence fly this time, but only because His Honor the Margrave might indeed have something to do with the theft. Menge has been spending heaps of coin lately, though to my knowledge he shouldn't have a copper to his name.
So, what now?
From what I've heard, Menge spends his nights at the docks, Witch Hunter's quarters. Maybe pay him a visit, ask where he's holding my gold for me.
So we do your dirty work while you sit around twiddling your thumbs.
Darling, when I'm able to make use of someone, I always do. It's convenient.
And safe. Come on, admit you're scared of Menge.
Of course I'm scared. Bloody dangerous horse, son. Triss would concur, I think.
Not in those words. But I do agree with the statement overall.
Doubt Menge will admit anything willingly.
As do I. Lucky I hired a witcher and a sorceress who've been through so much together to get this done.
What's our past got to do with it?
A great deal. Lovers will jump into the abyss for one another. Suits my needs perfectly. Namely, it greatly increases your chances of getting out of the hunter's barracks alive. With my treasure.
In other words, you're using us.
Using you? Never! Merely making the most of your mutual bond. Well, lovebirds, I really must be going. Good luck.
Thought you'd correct him. Say that we, you know.
Could have corrected him yourself.
True. But it's not an easy thing to say, is it? But we've strayed from our topic. Got a treasure to recover.
Triss, gotta tell you something. Dijkstra's gold, it's the last thing I care about.
Thought as much. This is about Ciri, isn't it?
Menge's got Dandelion locked up somewhere, and Dandelion saw Ciri.
That changes everything. Listen, meet me at midnight by the Chapel of the Eternal Fire, east of the harbor. We'll figure out a way to get into the Hunter's Barracks together.
All right, see you then, and thanks.
Next time on The Witcher 3.
Glad you're here. Listen, took a look at the building and it does not look good.
Mean it could use a bit of paint and spackle?
I mean, it's a damn fortress. High walls, guards at the gate, armed men everywhere. We could never sneak in, and fighting our way in won't work. Geralt, remember, I can take care of myself.
What are you talking about?
The hunters. They won't treat me like a lady, but I'll survive. Might hurt a bit, but... Ciri, she's what matters. Do what you need to do, no matter what happens.
Well, well. Triss Merigold. Giving up drowners for sorceresses?
Pays better.
Don't forget turning your cow's milk sour straight out of the udder.